I like them. I like to run the day because the bikes are very smart, and it gives you, it gives any rider an advantage because it'll allow you to lock. Like, if you're on a steep downhill and you have full ABS, you can't slow down because the wheel just keeps turning. There's no traction.
Yeah.
But if you put an off-road, it'll lock, release, lock, release, lock, release. So it'll allow it to bite, but won't allow it to skid.
Okay.
So also with this one, you have the rally.
Yeah.
So that is your ABS. You see that four? So I can go ABS 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So you can choose how much ski.
I'm not on the fly side.
No. But on this one, it's you can actually on the fly you can choose how much ABS to have and how much not. Okay, I will teach you that. The key is you put your bum outside.
Outside.
Now you have two ways. You have two ways you can pick up this bike. Okay? You can pick it up open or you can pick it up closed. Okay? So the one way is you turn the bar is this way, okay?
Okay.
And you grab the bar here,
yeah.
And you squat it, you must use your legs.
Yeah.
So you would go like this, and you pick it up like that, with that handlebar.
Yes.
The other way is you squat it here, and what you would do here is you grab it here, and then you do close, and you pull the bar all the way over. Okay, then you sit down,
and you squat.
And you squat. Don't use your arms and your back, you must use your legs.
Yeah.
And you squat up. And as you come up, you walk backwards. Okay. The other thing you can do is you can take the soil out from the wheels. So it goes like into the hole.
Uh-huh.
Then you're not picking it up so much. So if you are stuck on your own, you can move the soil under the wheels. Then it can roll a bit like into the hole. So it's halfway up and then you go up. The low speed one, he was asking about low speed. With low speed, it's all about your hips. So what you must do is, if I'm turning left, you put your weight on the outside peg. So the weight on the outside peg,
yep,
and you put your bum out like this. You stick your bum out, you stick your hips out, and you turn like that. Further out you are, the tighter you can turn. And then you turn really tight like that. And a good way to practice is you do figure of eight.
Eight.
So then you're turning left, turning right, turning left, turning right. And you learn to shift that weight. And then you go slow speed, bum out like that, and you turn it in. That's the other thing we can do is you can go up the hill here, you know? And we can come down the other side. And when you come down, try to go as slow as possible. You don't understand? Because then you're in control. And so you're stepping that front. Even if you stop, you stop and you go again. And that way you start to learn that downhill, downhill, downhill. And then obviously there's a lot of nice downhills here. I'm sure we can find some downhills.
Yep.
But going slow on the downhills, it's all about just feather, 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 feeling that control, feeling that balance. That's a good way to go.
Yeah.
So don't put anything heavy in here. You have to put something heavy
on the side.
The lower the better.
bend. So this one bends, that one comes straight. Like that. And then, yep, that's it. This leaf is going in there. It's coming out like that.
That's right here.
Okay.
Think of it with your arms. It's like shooting an arrow. So you're shooting to the inside, shooting to the inside, shooting to the inside like that. And that.
With the bike on the traction, okay, when you are coming fast around the corner,
on the street, you mean?
Yeah, just on a corner. Let's say it's cornering and it's flat ground and stuff, and if it's dirt, you know.
Okay.
What the bike wants to do is the bike wants to keep going straight. Yeah. So the wheels, as you're coming around, the wheels want to do that. You know, and do like a low slide, a low slide, you know what I mean? So if you're coming around, you're worried the bike's going to go away from you.
Yes.
Okay, so what you have to do is on dirt, the difference with a street bike is the bike, if it goes twitchy, you're like, whoa, crap, you know? But on dirt, it's normal. It does that. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, the way that you control that traction is you weight the outside foot peg. So if you put your weight on this side, it's going to make it go quicker. If you put your weight on this side, it keeps it in. So normally, if you look at the street bike races, okay, the street bike racer, he's coming around this corner. He's doing this. Just hold it up. Just go there. So the street bike racer, he's going like this. Up around the corner, because there's lots of traction. You see, but if you do that on dirt, that bike's gone. So on dirt, you do this. You see? So the bike leans, look where my bum is, it's half off. Half of it is off the seat. Okay? And my weight is here. Because I'm pushing it down. If you are sitting, sit right out. But if you are standing if it's off-road and it's bumping like this, it's always better to stand because then the bike, can move around and it doesn't affect you, you know? So like this would be like, if I'm coming around, you see this arm is straight because I'm going that way. This arm is bent. Hips are out. You can see this knee is pushing up against it. It's like that. That is your slow speed turn. You know, you think of it like this in your skiing, you know, with your knees and stuff. If you sit too much, when you get scared, you sit down. The problem when you sit down is this bike can't move. So you hit a rock and it goes like, and you find when you're sitting like this. You know what I mean? Because every time the bike moves, your whole body moves.
Yeah.
But if you are standing,
it's just the bike
that bike can move like this and you...
You become weightless.
Exactly. And I think you have this much suspension on a motorcycle. Now you stand up, you add another 40 centimeters of suspension.
Mm.
Oh, you see? And so it's just so much better if you're standing, you're like, bop, 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 hit stuff. You know, it's much, much easier. The other thing you should do is when you're standing, you grip with your knees.
Yeah.
So it should be like a horse. On a horse, you're not pushing the horse, you're not pulling the horse. You are neutral. That's it. So if you grip with your knees, if you are standing at any time, you should be able to let go of the bike. Then you know you are in the right position. So if you're riding and you feel this, you're not pushing, you're not pulling, then you are right. The other thing is people stand like this, and then they're like, oh, the bars are too short.
That's what I do.
Yeah. So your bum, you just push your bum out a little bit.
Half squat.
Yeah.
And a good way to practice, you can go up the hill here, you stop and you go again. And that way you start to learn that downhill. And then obviously there's a lot of nice downhill.
The more you can keep your bike happy, the better. So if you are braking hard, obviously the front suspension is compressed. If you're accelerating, the back is you want to be gentle on brakes, gentle on acceleration, especially in corners, that kind of stuff. And so you'll see, if you accelerate too hard on a corner, the bike naturally wants to brake traction.
Much traction here, but if you over accelerate, wheel will break and it will start to slide out. If you go back, the back wheel wants to slide out. The more you accelerate and the more you lie down, the more it wants to break. See, it wants to go. But if you go, you can lean it and go a lot softer and then it won't break. See, it won't break because I'm accelerating. So if you accelerate, if you're leaning on a turn and you give it, it's gonna come out. So you find that happy balance of like you want it to lean as much as possible, but you don't want to break the traction. You want to lean and just go like that. But if you under accelerate, then you fall over. When you see that corner, you'll see my arms are like this.
Yeah.
Okay. You'll see my bum's over. And you saw that last one, it started to lose traction.
Yeah.
You see, and you just let off a little, correct it, takes traction again.
Adjust?
Dab.
Yeah, adjust.
You want to adjust. Ideally, you don't want to put your foot down. If you put your foot, you must be ready for your foot to come this way.
Yeah.
So don't put your foot out.
Uh-huh.
If you turn your ankle like this,
yeah, okay.
Every time. But and that's one of those things that new guys damage, because they're putting their foot like this.
Yeah.
So you want it like that, but it is better if your foot never touches. Yeah, I was trying to make it just go a little bit, but it's hard to power slide on this because there's a lot of traction. So by the time you're at the point where you're breaking traction, you're so far over, it's gonna go, you know? Space, you know, and you're leaning and it's going, brake. And what you can do, obviously you can brake and go straight into a power slide even. You just go like this.
Oh yeah, we do this.
And you turn it around and then you go. The other thing you can do is if you're on a downhill and it's very, very steep and you're in a lot of trouble now and you're like, oh man, I'm really struggling. And you have to push your bike or something like that. You always, or even if you're sitting on it, but you can't, you know, it's very, very...
It's like you're very, losing control.
You're out of your depth. Turn off the engine. Put it into gear. And then you use this as a back brake. And you want to put your feet down. You don't want to stand up. Then you would be out of gear and you'd be going with your back brake like this. But if you start falling like this, then you have to let go of your back. Now you've only got front, then you ski the front and you fall.
100%.
So, yeah. So if you are worried and you have your feet down, like this now, it's in gear. So now I've got the front brakes, and if I release the back, you see, you, this one is like a brake in reverse. When it's in, it's off. When it's out, it's on. So then I can go like this. Obviously, normally you would just have the front brakes, you know? But now, if I'm walking, I can use the back. I release the back a little. Now I can control both wheels. And you see how much easier it is. If I did that without the back wheel, the front's locking, it's skiing, it's like this back wants to keep coming. So you can see now, look, it'll even stop here. Now if I pull this one, you see, then it wants to go forward. So it's like, does that make sense? That's another little trick. I want to show you the off-camber thing here quickly. Down. Now you can imagine, the more I'm leaning like this, the worse it's going to get. Also, if I put the weight on these inside peg here, you can see that bike's going to want to go more. But if you put the weight on the outside peg, like this, and now you push the bike in, now it's access to these kind of bikes. But if you have a chance, or you can have both, to ride a bike like this will make you a much better rider on a bike. Really, because you see here, look, I can show you this stuff. If I'm on that 790 and I make a mistake, it could cost a lot. And so you buy the bike you're going to use. Now if you're going to do long distance and stuff, a 1290 is a beautiful bike. The more off-road you're going, the smaller the bike you get. That 1290, you put some knobblies on it and you ride it properly, it's the bike will not hold you back. You can't blame the bike. Front brake, you know, but can you see it's half the distance to the back brake. I was more or less the same speed. It's a little difficult to see, but it was more or less. But you can see it's half the distance. You know, now if you do them both together, you should get even less. Obviously here we can't do exact speeds and stuff, so it might not work out this time, but brake helps, you know, but the front brake
stops
is the golden rule, because the more I brake, and if I can keep the bar straight, it pushes that wheel into the ground, and it takes all that speed and it pushes it into the ground and it stops you a lot quicker. The back brake, you saw, you slide, you know
what
I mean?
What you've done here is one shot.
Yeah, you can lock it up, but obviously you've got to be able
to hold it there.
Yeah, you got it, because obviously I'm doing like an emergency brake. You normally wouldn't brake like that unless you have to. But you can see, I mean, I was trying to keep it at 40 kilometers an hour. That's what I was trying to do. So, I mean, what is that? That's like 4 meters to stop from 40 kilometers an hour. That's fantastic, you know what I mean? To be able to stop in such a small space of time. And so you want to be able to get on it straight away. And it's easier if you're standing as well, because you can keep those bars straight. But obviously with these bikes, they also have ABS.
Yeah.
So if you've got your ABS on, you can flip and pull that thing as hard as you want. It's not going to lock up. It's going to keep it like that. See, your arms are straight, putting it back. If you're sitting like this, you're going to start. Ever pushing a bike forwards, you're normally doing something wrong, because the bike can move itself forwards. So if you ever find you pushing your bike, think, what am I doing? I must make the thing turn. Also, when you roll backwards, if you're pulling like this, also think, is there a better way I can do this? So if you have to turn around, for instance, in a shop, in a small space, and there's a curb or there's a rock, a good thing is to do that. So if you're going to turn around, always turn around against the hill. So if you're on a slope, don't try to turn that way, because then you get there. Now you're trying to push back up the hill. Just go to the hill and you just use the hill. Another good thing is always, if you are struggling on terrain and you're getting stuck and you're struggling, pick a spot where you can pull off from. A lot of guys will get stuck and they'll stop where they get stuck. And now they get tired and they recover. And now they start again, but now they are stuck. So they're like, and by the time, 10 seconds later, they're tired already. So rather work through and stop where you can pull off. You know what I mean? So like, there was the one section in Morocco, or no, it was the Dakar, where they've got these dunes.
Yeah.
Small dunes, you know, maybe as high as this. Yeah. But it's like this, and it's soft sand. And you see the guy gets stuck in the bottom. Oh, and he stops and he's like, and he stops and he recovers. Then he goes, whoa, and he comes out over the dune, whoa, into the next one, whoa, gets stuck, and he stops. And then he goes, and then he stops, recovers, and he does the same. And he did that so many times. Whereas I'm watching this, and for me, because I struggle with because of my legs and stuff, I've like learned to kind of cheat you know, how to
find a better solution.
That's exactly it. And so what I do is I would go on top of the dune. And I stop on the top of the dune and I rest. I'm not stuck. I choose to stop. I stop, I rest, I'm fine. I look at the dip, I'm recovered. Okay. Next one. Then I stop. And then I rest. And then I go again. And you just slowly, and you use half the energy of the other way. So it's all...